in the past few years up to today, we have watched how corruption has become endemic, massive, systemic, and rampant in our politics. The faces and symptoms of corruption are, you are very familiar with them, overpriced projects, multi-billion scams of various kinds, election manipulation, anomalous transactions, bribery of both high and low, unsolved murders, especially of media practitioners. Kaya nga masasabi natin, corruption is a social and moral cancer. What are the consequences of corruption? Corruption, foremost in political election, damages political legitimacy, integrity, and competence. Corruption impedes economic development, worsens income inequity and poverty, endangers public order and safety. Corruption results in bureaucratic inefficiency and demoralization. Kaya nga ang sabi ng isa, corruption begets bad governance, bad politics, and bad governance, bad politics beget further corruption. Is it any wonder then that our country is tagged as the most corrupt country in Asia and the 11th most corrupt among 102 countries in the world? Ito kinuha namin sa Transparency International. If we are not horrified, if we are not disgusted and exasperated, if we are not enraged by these realities, can we still say that we love our country? Where is our patriotism? In this country, we identify ourselves so easily with victims of pickpockets and snatchers. And we easily throw them, these small-time thieves, to almost forever languish in prison. But when it comes to big-time crooks and public officials stealing billions upon billions of the people's money, it takes forever to prove their crime. There is so much embarrassing hesitation and false respect to start mounting a campaign to show that corruption is the worst form of crime because it kills the common good. It kills the poor and the hungry. It kills the country. It violates God's commandment, thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not kill. When there is corruption at the top, it becomes nearly impossible to eradicate corruption at the lower level of government. There is no moral ascendancy to demand honesty, decency, and transparency. And where there is bad governance, it becomes harder to liberate people from the shackles of poverty and hunger. So much has been said about the roots of the present political crisis. And some people say it is now the time to move past this crisis. It is now the time to move past this crisis. But under these circumstances, 2010 elections, if they ever come, will only reproduce the crisis. The appearance of new faces in government may lull us into thinking that we have survived the crisis and that a new era is upon us. But as the worsening poverty and hunger figures in our country, as our country showed, unless we institute dramatic changes in the way we conduct our politics, government will sooner than we think become irrelevant to the lives of the Filipinos.